Hey y'all, my name is Jenna Wallace, and I just recently retired as Oregon FFA's state vice president. So I'm a past state officer now, and I'm originally from Hermiston, Oregon. So Eastern Oregon, maybe you know where it's at, maybe you don't, but that's totally cool. Right now, I am in Washington, D.C., and I'm currently checking out some colleges with my family, trying to figure out what my future looks like. So in the spirit of that, we're going to go ahead and take the next 30 seconds or so and turn to our partners and tell them one place we really, really want to visit. What's at the top of our bucket list, a place that we really want to visit. Could be anywhere in the world, could be here in the United States, doesn't matter. We're going to tell our partner one place we want to visit. So our partner could be someone, if we're in person in class, it could be someone that we're sitting right next to, or if we're at home, our partner could be a piece of paper. It's totally cool. Let's use that and go ahead and share one place we really, really want to visit. Let's take the next 30 seconds. Go for it. All right, let's bring it back in. We are so excited that we got to share our places that we want to visit. I'm sure there are some places like Antarctica, Europe, places in Europe, maybe some states here in the United States. That's super awesome. I don't know, I kind of want to visit Russia someday. That would be very interesting. I think that'd be pretty cool. But so now that we have some of those ideas of places we might want to visit in our mind, we're just going to set those aside for just a second. We're going to be talking about how to live in the present today. And I kind of got us off to a rough start. Daydreaming about places that we want to visit is a prime example of how to not live in the present. So if we daydream about traveling to Paris, France one day, probably not doing a very good job of living here in the present right now. So with that in mind, we're going to learn some different ways to live in the present and learn about this really cool word called FIKA. FIKA is a word to describe how to live in the present in Swedish. So how many of us have ever heard of the word FIKA before? Yeah, probably not, right? It's a Swedish word, and we're probably not super familiar with it. So we're going to learn more about this concept of FIKA because it does a really great job of highlighting the important parts about living in the present. And then we're going to dive deep into how we can live in the present. And we'll round out our workshop with actually taking a moment to live in the present and do something really cool. So let's go ahead and let's get started. All right, so the first thing we're going to need to do is get a definition of this word FIKA, because we probably have no idea really what it means other than it has to do with living in the present. So right now what we're going to do is take the next 30 seconds to grab a piece of paper and a writing utensil so we can get writing on what the definition of FIKA is. Let's go ahead, take 30 seconds and grab that piece of paper and writing utensil right now.
Thought I'd never be waking on the kitchen floor, but here I lie, not the first time. Now my morning has broken and it brings the fear. My mind's falling, then I feel my pulse quickening, but regrets can't change anything. Yeah, I feel my pulse quickening.
All right, y'all, we are back from gathering our writing utensils. So now we're going to take the next couple of minutes to write down the definition of FIKA. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen right now, and then we'll take the next minute or so to write down the definition of FIKA. All right, here we go. I'm going to pull up that definition right now. Go ahead and share our screen, and you can take a look at what this definition of FIKA is. The definition of FIKA is a moment to slow down and appreciate the good things in life. So let's go ahead and take a moment and write down this definition on our piece of paper. All right, y'all. So hopefully we have that definition written down. If we don't, I'll leave this up here for a couple more seconds so we can get that definition down. But this is the definition of FIKA that we are going to be working with today. So anytime you hear me reference living in the present moment, we're really talking about this definition of FIKA. So FIKA is a moment to slow down and appreciate the good things in life. Really what this means and why it's a Swedish word is because in Swedish culture, it is a time to take a break from work, whether that's in the middle of the day, in the evening, whatever, and just take a break. Do something else, have a conversation with friends, maybe read a book. In Sweden, the traditional thing is to enjoy a cup of coffee and a pastry. So we're going to take this definition of FIKA and try to translate it to our everyday lives of living in the present. So that is our definition that we're going to be working with today. All right, y'all, now that we know what our definition of FIKA is, we're going to try to start to understand how we can translate it into our everyday lives. So what we're going to do for the next 30 seconds is we're going to get up and take a seat anywhere around our classroom. And if this means that we're at home enjoying this workshop in our bedroom or our kitchen, we're going to do the same thing. We're just going to move to a different side of the room, different seat. Just make sure we're staying socially distanced if we need to be, of course. But let's go ahead, get up for the next 30 seconds and find a spot somewhere else around the room to take a seat. Let's go for it. Go for it right now. All right, y'all, we're back and we are hopefully in our spots, whether that's on the floor, on a desk, on a table, whatever. We are sitting in a new spot. And if we have to stand, that's okay too. What we're going to do for the next couple of minutes is we are going to listen to my voice with our eyes closed. Yep, it's going to be kind of silly at first, but that's totally all right. Because what it's going to do is place us in a scenario, and we're going to try and imagine if that scenario is a FIKA moment, a moment to slow down and enjoy the good things in life, or not a FIKA moment. And we're going to listen to two scenarios. So let's go ahead and get our eyes closed right now, and we will take a look at the first scenario. So close your eyes, close your eyes, close your eyes. All right, now that our eyes are closed, I'm going to go ahead and read our first scenario. Imagine yourself walking around Disneyland. You spent the last 6 hours riding all of the rides that you possibly can, and you're having the best day of your life. All you smell is the deliciously sweet scent of cotton candy and dreams. You hear the sounds of roller coasters buzzing over your head and children screaming of joy. Your mom tells you that it's almost time to head back to the hotel where you're staying, but you walk past a roller coaster that is bigger than anyone you've ever been on. You're kind of scared, but you know that you love roller coasters, and you'd probably have a ton of fun. Despite this, you walk past the roller coaster and head back to your hotel without getting on the ride. Later that night in the hotel, you feel deep regret for not jumping on that roller coaster, because chances are you won't be back at Disneyland until you take your own kids there in 20 years. Let's go ahead and open our eyes. All right, y'all, with that scenario pictured in our head, Disneyland, not getting on the ride, even though you want to, let's go ahead, turn to our partner for the next 30 seconds, someone we're sitting next to, someone that's nearby, and let's share with them whether or not we think this was a FIKA moment. A moment to slow down and appreciate the good things in life. So to recap, we're going to, for the next 30 seconds, turn to someone we're sitting by and share with them whether we think this was a FIKA moment or not. Go for it. All right, so we're ready for our second scenario. So whether or not you thought that was a FIKA moment, hopefully you justified that with your partner who you spoke to. But we're going to take the next minute or so to read our second scenario. So let's go back to that place where we were sitting, our new spot around the room, and we are going to close our eyes once again. So we'll take a couple seconds to get there, and then we're going to close our eyes. Close your eyes, close your eyes, close your eyes. All right, here we go. Ready for the second scenario. Imagine you're sitting in a window seat on a flight to your favorite destination. You just woke up from a nap and start to open your eyes. You're feeling so excited to land and start experiencing incredible adventures. Then you look out the window and see the most beautiful sunset you've ever seen. It's dark oranges that fade into golden beams of light with cotton candy clouds drifting over the horizon. You begin to pull out your phone to take an Instagram-worthy picture, but realize that in that moment, you wouldn't be able to capture how truly beautiful the sunset is. So instead, you put your phone back on your lap and choose to bask in the beauty of the colors. The plane lands and you feel fulfilled because of the amazing sunset you just witnessed and that you were fully encapsulated in the entire experience. Go ahead and open your eyes. We're going to do the same thing that we did with the previous scenario, but we're going to find someone new to share our thoughts with. So let's find a new partner and share with them whether or not we think that was a true FIKA moment. Go for it. All right, let's go ahead and head back to our seats. All right, y'all, so we just found out some really cool scenarios, maybe that we put ourselves in, and decided whether or not we thought those were a FIKA moment. So let's go ahead and move on to what we're going to do next. Taking a moment to reflect on those scenarios that we just listened to, thought of, and shared with our partners, we're going to pull out that piece of paper that we wrote the definition of FIKA on, and we're going to write on that again. So the question that we are going to answer on that piece of paper, and we don't need to write it down or anything like that, but we're going to answer the question, what do those scenarios make us realize about how we're living our lives right now? The scenarios that we just listened to, that one was a FIKA moment and one was not a FIKA moment, and we can go ahead, I'll share the answer with that. Our first one was technically a FIKA moment at the beginning. We were having so much fun enjoying Disneyland, but towards the end, we regretted things, and regret is not something that symbolizes a FIKA moment. So our second one is the true FIKA moment. Putting our phones down, just really basking in the beauty of those colors of the sunset. That was taking a moment to slow down and appreciate the good things in life. That's a FIKA moment. So reflecting on those two scenarios, what do they make us realize about how we're living our lives right now? Are we living out tons of FIKA moments all the time? Or are we starting to realize that maybe we're not very good at living in the present? I'll be honest, I am not the best at living in the present, but we're just going to take a moment, about 30 seconds, to reflect on our piece of paper what those scenarios make us realize about how we're living our lives right now, and we're just going to jot down some thoughts. All right, y'all. Let's go ahead, take 30 seconds, and write that down right now. All right, y'all. Hopefully we have some of those responses written down on our piece of paper and we're ready to move on. Let's take the next 30 seconds to get into a group of three. 30 seconds, get into a group of three, go right now. All right, y'all, we're in our groups of threes and we are ready to get going with our next activity. Awesome job. For the next 2 full minutes, we are going to be looking at a screen on a slide. And we are going to ask our groups these questions on the slide. And we're just gonna go around the circle, ask the questions, answer the questions, be vulnerable, be brave, tell the truth about some of those questions, but doesn't need to be super in depth. We're just gonna answer these questions, what first comes to our head, and then we're gonna move on to the next question. I think there's about 4 or 5 questions on this slide. All right, we're gonna take the next 2 minutes and do this. All right, y'all, so hopefully we had some time to answer those questions with our groups and get some really cool discussion out of that. So let's just go through some of these questions real fast. What sometimes stops you from participating in an activity? Whether that's anxiety, sheer doubt that you'll even like the activity at all, maybe you're just kind of not really into it, whatever that is, think about that. What stops you from participating in an activity? What holds you back from living in the present and enjoying that activity? What is something you've always wanted to do but haven't? And sometimes things that we really want to, really want to do, like skydiving, where you have to be, I think, 18, 4, and we're 16. That just makes sense why you can't do it, right? But if we've really wanted to go to this restaurant in town and we haven't done that yet, let's try to live in the present more. Try out this local business and see if we like it. Number three, do we actively show gratitude? Do we say thank you? Do we ask politely? Do we actively show our gratitude for people, live in the present by acknowledging what they've done for us and how they've helped us throughout our time in FFA, in school, just in life in general? Are you aware of the small moments in life? I'm sure you've heard this before, but the small moments are usually the big ones, right? So maybe you'll remember this vacation to New York for the rest of your life, if you ever go to New York. But what you'll probably remember more is the time that your teacher takes to help you with a homework assignment, or the time that your ag advisor helps you prepare for a CDE or an LDE. Those are the small moments in life that really have the biggest impact, right? Do you worry about the future? Now, this is a big one because I'm sure all of us, if not most of us, worry about what our future looks like. And I definitely do too. But sometimes we have to take a step back and realize that the future is going to happen, but we have the present here for us right now. So it's more important to have fun in the present sometimes than it is to worry about the future. So those are the questions that we asked our groups. Hopefully we got some really cool responses from that. And we're going to go ahead and move on to our next activity. And we're going to do that right now. With those questions that we just answered in mind, we are going to uncover five different ways to actually live in the present moment and enjoy those FIKA moments. And we're going to take the next minute or so to get those written down on our same piece of paper that we've been writing everything down on. So let's get out that piece of paper and a writing utensil again, and we're going to be writing down five behaviors to live in the present moment. Let's go ahead and take a look at that screen right now with those five behaviors, and we'll take the next 2 minutes to go ahead and get these behaviors written down on our piece of paper. Go for it. All right, let's go ahead and take a moment and talk about these five behaviors. So the first one is giving thanks. So give thanks is obviously super important, we know that, but in terms of living in the present and enjoying these FIKA moments, giving thanks is actually one of the number one things that we can do. If we say thank you, if we appreciate what people do for us and express our gratitude, that immediately sends us into living in the present moment, because we were there and we were thanking them for something that they did for us or for helping us out, anything like that. Giving thanks is really important to live in the present moment. Number two is live in the now, right? This seems like a big overall encompassing aspect. However, living in the now is essential to live out our FIKA moments. If we don't worry about what's coming up next, if we're just here present with the people in our class, with the people in our FFA chapters, well, chances are we'll probably get a lot more done. And second of all, have a lot more fun. Number three is smile. Now, this sounds really silly. I know, smiling is so much fun. Maybe tons of us love it. Maybe some of us don't. But smiling is super important because what it does is it sends you into a happy state immediately. So if we're not really good at smiling, we're not really good at being happy all the time, that's okay. But what we can do is try to seek out those experiences that help us live in the present and smile, because smiling does have this really cool way of making you happy almost immediately. Number four is forgive past hurts. Now, this one's a little bit more challenging. Actually, four and five are probably the most challenging. Forgiving past hurts can be a lot more complex than what is just read on our screen. Each of us have gone through completely different things in our lives, but forgiving past hurts can be as simple as a best friend quarrel and just trying to get over those moments. So instead of living in the past and reflecting on this drama that might have happened in your life, you can go ahead and move forward from that and live in the present moment. Now, what I'm not saying is to forgive every trauma that's ever happened in your life. By no means am I saying that. But we can pick and choose to forgive those past hurts that will help us go ahead and move on into the next things in our life. Living in the present moment, not worrying about what happened to us in the past. Number five is overcome worrying. Now, this is probably one a lot of us struggle with, and me too. But the best way to overcome worrying sometimes is to find what we really love and help us kind of de-stress. So for me, I love listening to my favorite music, maybe reading a good book. Prayer is a really great way for me. If that's not for you, that's totally all right. But we got to find those things that we really like so that we can overcome those worrying moments and try to move past those so we can live in the present and create that many more awesome memories. So hopefully we have all five of those behaviors written down on our piece of paper right now. Let me go ahead and stop sharing our screen, and we will go ahead and move on to our next activity. All right, our next activity is really where we're going to put our living in the present skills, our FIKA moment skills, to the test. So what we're going to be doing is creating a handful of gratitude, So if we are able to, I would love if we could write on our hands and create this handful of gratitude. So if you need a pen or a Sharpie or something like that, go for it. If you are not comfortable writing on your hand, that's totally all right. What we can do instead is on that piece of paper, we can go ahead and trace our hand with pencil or pen or whatever, and we'll just use that piece of paper. But if possible, I'd love to see that hand written on with a pen or a Sharpie. So let's go ahead and gather up those necessary materials right now. You need a pen, Sharpie, pencil, paper, whatever. Let's get those for the next 30 seconds. Okay, so we have our materials, hopefully. I have my Sharpie ready to write on my hand. Again, if you can do that, awesome. If not, totally okay. Go ahead and write on that piece of paper and trace your hand instead. So what we're going to do for the next couple of minutes, and I do want to make sure y'all have plenty of time to brainstorm, because this is an awesome way that we are going to live out a FIKA moment. But remember that number one behavior that was giving thanks. So we're going to actively express our gratitude right now with a handful of gratitude. So with this pen or marker or whatever you have, we're going to take the next couple of minutes and think of a person that we're really, really grateful for. And then think of an experience that we're really, really grateful for. So we're going to think of those two things. And then we're going to also think of what they did for us, how they helped us, all of that good stuff. So to recap really fast, we're going to think of one person we're really grateful for and why, and one experience we're really grateful for and why. And we're just going to go ahead and either write that on our hand or on our paper. Let's take the next 2 minutes and do this right now. All right, y'all. So we are super ready to share our responses, hopefully. We're going to go ahead and take the next 30 seconds, turn to our partner, and share with them both of our people and our experiences. 30 seconds, let's go for it right now. Sweet. So just took some time to share with our partners. I'll go ahead and share mine really fast. One person I'm really thankful for is my aunt, because she is here in DC and I'm staying with them. She's let me stay here. She's shown me around DC, helping me figure out what colleges I want to go to. So I'm super thankful for her. And then one experience that I'm really thankful for is state office, because it gave me the chance to be a past state officer and be with you today. So I'm really excited about that. If you have ever wanted to run for state office, I totally encourage you to do so, even though it's a little bit different in Minnesota than it is in Oregon. Super, super fun altogether. Absolutely love meeting all the different people from all the different state associations. And I think that's something really cool that you can be a part of if you become a state officer. So with that in mind, we're just going to go ahead and start wrapping up today. Let's go ahead and do that. So the way we're going to wrap up today is we are going to reflect on this idea of FIKA moments on our piece of paper one last time. So as teenagers, we are so used to being stressed out about exams, keeping up on the latest trends, and posting those Instagram-worthy pictures. But really, if we just take a step back and remember that definition of FIKA, a moment to slow down and appreciate the good things in life, we don't necessarily need to worry about all of those things. We can have fun and enjoy the present and have a really great, awesome life experience without having to worry about all of those different things. So it is now our goal, and hopefully we will be able to accomplish this, to live out FIKA moments a lot more. So what we're going to do for the next 30 seconds is we're going to think of one daily goal we can come up with and do that's achievable, that's accessible for us to do to live out those FIKA moments a little bit more. So for example, one thing that I might do is put my phone down during mealtimes. So I'm usually pretty good about this during like dinner and stuff with family, but when I'm with my friends enjoying lunch at school, I tend to be on my phone a little bit. I'm sure some of us do that too. So maybe something I can do is put my phone down during lunch, and that is my daily goal. All right, so let's go ahead, take the next 30 seconds to a minute and brainstorm one daily goal that's achievable that we can do to live in the present moment just a little bit more. Let's go for it. We have our goals done now. Awesome. So y'all, one of the last things we're going to do is take the next 30 seconds and share with our partner that one goal we want to accomplish on the daily. 30 seconds. Let's share with someone we're sitting next to that goal we just came up with. Go for it. All right, so hopefully we had some time to share with our partner that super cool goal we came up with. Thank you all for working extremely hard today. I hope that FIKA is now able to be a little bit more translatable into your lives and we understand the present moment a little bit more. So today, basically what we did is we established what FIKA meant, established what could have stopped us from experiencing it in the past, and then actively participated in some true FIKA moments with our handful of gratitude. And then lastly, we just created some awesome goals for our future and shared with our partner how we're going to get that done. So I hope that you take some time to recognize the FIKAs in your everyday and take advantage of them because there is a lot of beauty in the present moment. So let's hold up that paper that we have of our FIKA definition and share with everyone in the class the awesome stuff that we did today. And remember that FIKA is a moment to slow down and appreciate the good things in life. I appreciate being here with you all today and hope you have a great rest of your day. Thank you.